Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Dennis Prager Show. Let's go to Mark in Gallup, New Mexico. Hi there, Mark of Gallup. Dennis Prager.
Well, hi, Dennis. I've always known you to be a man who rarely, if ever, uses hyperbole.
Correct. I hate it. Yeah.
Yes, yes. But the other day you said people who don't know Hillary is corrupt have a character flaw. And I was discussing this with my conservative ex-girlfriend, Nancy, and it seemed a little over the top, and I just wanted to get your thoughts on that. It seemed to me like they just haven't done extensive research.
No, I don't think so. I think it is willful ignorance, and that's shameful. You see, it's not subtle. The woman's corrupt. Her husband is corrupt. And if you don't know that, it is because you have decided to ignore it. Now, if you say, I know she's corrupt. However, I will vote for any Democrat over any Republican. That ends the issue.
But there's only two places they're going to be able to find that out. Talk News and Fox Radio.
No, it's not true. It's really not true. I mean, everybody has covered, just to differing extents, the level of her corruption and the level of his corruption. I mean, if you don't know that he used officers when he was governor of Texas to procure women, of Arkansas, and if you don't know about the foundation's raising money while she is a Secretary of State, paying her husband fortunes of money to give speeches in the poorest countries in the world or before the richest corporations of the world, and then being okayed by the U.S. government shortly thereafter, it's because you have decided not to know about it. So again, if you say, yes, she's corrupt, and the truth is, I will vote for any Democrat over any Republican, that ends the discussion. But if you deny that she is corrupt, there is something wrong with your character. I believe that. By the way, if you denied that, if you're a Republican and denied that Donald Trump's comments about John McCain were despicable, there's something wrong with your character.
Sure, sure. Okay, yeah, that does make sense. I guess I saw it more as ignorance, but yeah, you're making a good point.
Thank you so much. Appreciate it. Yep, got to be fair on both sides. And I will vote essentially for just about any Republican over any Democrat. That is correct. Because in the larger scheme of things, the damage done by the Democrats is close to irreversible. And look at your universities. They have been raped by the left. The only rape culture in the left is the culture of the left. The only rape culture on the university, there is a rape culture. It is the rape of the university. Well, you know, to deny this, to live through it and to deny it is inexcusable. I'm sorry. See, I have more respect if you really want to just, if you chant, as Jesse Jackson did, hey, hey, ho, ho, Western Civ has got to go, and you believe Western civilization is disgusting, and certainly, at the very least, not better than any other, then at least you are consistent with your perverse principles. But if you think Western civilization is good and deny that the left is destroying it, then there is really something wrong with you. You have decided to live in willful ignorance. That is what is at stake here, folks. That is what is at stake. If my candidate is deeply flawed, that's really sad. I worked very hard against his nomination. But he is the nominee, and he is the only thing that could stop the Democrats from winning. The only thing. Not libertarians and their onanistic desire to put people up for office. And not the Greens. Okay? It's either a Democrat or a Republican. All right? You can fantasize all you like. Fantasies are fun. Fantasies are fun. That's why people fantasize. But mature people should know the distinction between a fantasy and reality. The reality is it's a Democrat or Republican who is going to be the next president. That's the only reality. Everything else is fantasy to make yourself feel good about yourself. People should be mature enough to understand it's a Democrat or a Republican. That's your choice. It may stink. Much of life is of olfactory challenged. Okay? Let me put it to you that way. Wow, this is about as passionate a third hour on a Friday as I can remember in a long time.